Alright. Hello and welcome to a game called The Darkness. And I guess we'll just get started by checking what the hell we need to do, because I've sort of forgotten. That's not the button. Alright. Gotta go to the inventory. Anthony's letter. Well, if anyone wants to read that, just pause video. So, I remember something about this. So, Lower East Side, Green Olive Grove Restaurant. So, Lower East Side. Lower East Side. Alright, Lower East Side.
Jackie.
It's impossible to see.
My Aunt Sarah. Now, she taught me about life. After I left the orphanage, she was the one person who cared for me. And she loved you. Now, when her husband, Jimmy Franchetti, died, the family forgot about her. Except for the older guys. And me.
Really hard to see. It's really lit. And as far as I can tell, it doesn't say nothing. So, lower whatever side, Lower East Side, whatever. Green Olive. Raspberry. I remember something about raspberry.
Jack! Oh, I've been so worried about you. I heard you were gone, and I feared the worst. You look thin. Have you been eating? You come on inside. Come on. You want some minestrone? I know what's happened, Jackie. And you know how much I've always loved you. You know how I hate it when our family turns against each other like this.
Aunt Sarah. I lost her. And what the hell am I gonna do without Jenny?
It's terrible. I cleaned out her apartment. She was waiting for you, Jackie. Anyone but you could see it. Oh, you should have taken her away from this place when you had the chance. And now you've got to take care of it.
I'm really sorry for the way things came out, Aunt Sarah. Now you know that I never meant any disrespect to you and the family. But I'm gonna have to take a stand against Paulie and Eddie Schrote and punish them. For what they did.
I know. And some of the older men, they'll support your decision, Jackie. But you're gonna have to earn their trust. If you were to hurt Paulie's operation, they might consider joining you. They want things back the way they used to be.
I'm gonna tear his face off, Aunt Sarah. Pardon my language. But I'm gonna rip that dirty little motherfucker's face off and feed his lips to the fucking rats! But I can't kill that little fucking scumbag. your blessing. You know that.
Well, kill is such a dirty word. But do what you have to do. And understand that you won't get to Pauly unless you go through his police dog first. The only way to Pauly is through Captain Eddie Schrute. Now, I happen to know he has an apartment up by Gun Hill. And I spoke to Jimmy the Grape, and he's arranged for a man named Abe Hunter to let you into the building. I suggest you go there and take up Jimmy's offer of help while you can.
All right, let me just read back something about... Okay, Gun Hill. Gun Hill. A used service store across train tracks at Fulton Street Station. Okay, I have to go back to the Fulton Station, whatever.
It's like I have everything to live for, and nothing to gain. I got nothing worth having without you. At least I got a purpose. And that's tearing Eddie Schrute into 1,000 pieces. It's my reason to live. Anyone who says the subway is dangerous never sat in the back of a yellow cab going the wrong way at 90 miles an hour through the Midtown Tunnel with a guy who can't speak a lick of English, my buddy, Crazy Abdul.
As long as you didn't tread on any dead hookers.
I still can't see. So, the Fulton Street Station, is this the service tunnel? Wait, hold on.
What's at City Hall Station?
I'm trying to find my brother, Ernie. I think he went down that way. You see Ernie DeVore, you tell him his brother Mitch is waiting for him. You tell him to get his sorry ass back here.
I guess I could look around. Or... I guess not. Is there something that needs to be done here?
Ordinary, dull, pointless maggots!
I guess it's not something I can do. Still need to find wherever this, whatever it was, and the Fulton Station. Is that it? Gun Hill? Gun Hill. Alright.
Then again, you should see his bad side. I try not to judge, but for what he did to you, both sides are as good as dead.
Well, you took your sweet time, didn't you? I'm Abe Hunter. I don't know where the fuck you been. What? You hit traffic or something? All right. Schroat's up in his place. He's been there about an hour, maybe. Five will get you 10. He won't be expecting no company. Only about 5 people even know where he lives.
Thanks for the info. Now, how do I get in?
Listen, ride up in the elevator and go straight in. Follow the stink. You can't fucking miss it. All right, here you go, pal. Okay, so you got the key to Schroat's apartment. The elevator's over there.
All right.
I'm gonna redeck
that adjective. Where the hell did I go? I'm confused on where to go.
Death will not betray you.
I am here again. Alright, I'm down here. Oh, I see him. Oh, whoops. I just missed him. And I am really not there. Yeah. so I just had to leave. What am I doing now?
Anyone who says the subway is dangerous never sat in the back of a yellow cab going the wrong way at 90 miles an hour through the Midtown tunnel with a guy who can't speak a lick of English, my buddy, Crazy Abdul.
Alright, let me just look at the objectives here. Butcher. I have to find Butcher. That I don't know where the hell to go. Maybe I just need a phone.
Some old men with their dicks flapping in the breeze and their noses seriously out of joint, you know what I mean? And that little schmuck Paulie's gone too far. He's got some fucking West Coast assholes doing all our meaningful labor. Jesus Christ, we've been earners for this family for more years than I care to remember. And now this.
What do you say I put him over a barrel and show him the true spirit of family loyalty?
I knew we could count on you, Jackie. There's an entire gang of these idiots. We need you to put them in the ground, one by one. Now, the first one's been tailing your Aunt Sarah, but don't think she don't know every move he makes.
Okay, so I should go to Aunt Sarah, but also, what's the butcher?
Sounds like a plan. So where's he keeping this bag of goodies?
Well, as you might expect, Eddie and his goons snag a lot of confiscated goods for themselves. They stash most of it in the old Turkish baths. It's hard to get there, though, if you don't know how. But from Fulton, there's a connection through the old City Hall station. You'll need to get past the gate between Fulton and City Hall. But Schroed's gang makes damn sure it's always locked. However, someone whispered in my ear that they keep a key hidden somewhere in the public toilets at Fulton Street Station.
Okay. I'm off to grab Paulie and Short Fucker's piece of candy. Thanks, Butch.
Be careful, Jackie. Go to the old Turkish baths and get that suitcase. Then meet me at those same public toilets at Fulton Street Station. The ones where they keep the key to the gate. I'll be waiting there for you when you come back.
Alright, so I need to go to the toilets.
No.
where to go.
This is City Hall. You know, it used to be a subway station, but it pretty much went to hell a few years ago. It's the only way through to where I need to go, back to the motherfuckers who killed you.
Go back the way you came, pal. Cops shut down the entrance to the old Turkish Baths a year ago.
By special order from Captain Edward Strode. Did he hear it? That cocksucker Strode stole our best hangout.
Why don't you tell me what you know about Strode?
Eddie Strode is the biggest cocksucker on this side of the river. That fucking guy broke my brother's leg one time because he didn't know the capital of Denmark. I told him it was Copenhagen.
Tell me about the Turkish baths.
And you know another thing, we used to have a passage down to the old baths. They closed the place down after a couple of old ladies drowned one time. It was the warmest place in the city to sleep on a cold night. That bastard Eddie Strode stole it from us. Oh, hey. Good luck getting in there, pal. You need a compass and a half a ton of dynamite.
Okay,
hey. I wouldn't try going in there if I was you. The entrance is blocked. Besides, you don't want to get close to DeVile's people.
Drink to that!
damn it. Exactly. That.
Stop hitting yourself! It all makes sense. Violence is the answer.
Okay, there we go. Was as simple as that. Gonna stop anytime soon. Don't really understand what I'm trying to do here.
You lied to me! This wasn't the deal!
Isn't this that guy? Happening. That's interesting. I guess this was just some side area. How do I get out of here? Somehow I think that did it. Oh man, that was it. I'm just, I don't even know how I would have figured that out. I think something popped up.
These are the old Turkish baths. Schrodt's secret warehouse full of stolen evidence. But I got a little birthday surprise waiting for me. Courtesy of good old Butcher Joyce. All I gotta do is get through half a legion of bank cops, find that suitcase, and bring it back to Butcher.
Let's kill something.
latch. This one's never squealed by itself.
Well, then what the hell is wrong with it? Shit!
Thank you. I see you, asshole!
Shit!
Take a dive!
Thing or two about ambushes, having set up most of Paulie's business in that regard for years. So I know when I'm about to be on the receiving end. Eddie's boys are gonna be out here intent on blowing my brains out. These fucking morons must think I was born yesterday.
I don't know who you pissed off, but you did a fine job. Hey, I seen about 20 or 30 cops down there. Heavy shit, SWAT, and everything. Make sure you watch your back, son. You got half of the NYPD waiting for you down there.
All right. I mean, if they're all bunched up, they'll be easy pickings.
Around here for? This place was fine till you came here. Psst. Hey, buddy. Keep an eye out down there, okay? You go and fix this. Come on, go! Go, 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 go!
Break Trotsky's ice pick!
Shoot someone.
Thank you.
fight fire with fire. That's what I always say. My Uncle Paulie always goes for the spectacular when he's breaking somebody's balls. Let's see how he likes it when I do the same to his main man, Eddie.
Say, did you see my brother?
Well, I saw him, but I think he's kind of reluctant to meet up with you. He's got serious people problems.
Oh, my brother Ernie's always been the family freak. Hey, but thanks for trying. Here.
Second now.
But first, I'm gonna put a bomb in that suitcase.
Okay.
Be it for this part. Goodbye.